Shadow. Well, I mean, it has a lot to do with our way of being human, especially as a social creatures. There wouldn't be a shadow if there was only one individual. Okay, so things get pushed in your shadow because as you're growing up, like babies don't have shadows, they start encountering the world and they realize that some traits are beneficial and some are not, right? So masturbating in public is something that you shouldn't do, maybe.
Right.
But also there are other positive things, like in some cultures, really being amazing at something. Let's say you're, again, I'm gonna use stereotypical Midwestern culture, being an amazing dancer if you're a little boy. Light on your feet, spry, quick. Those aren't admirable either. So those things all get pushed into the shadow. I think James Hillman maybe is the one who Robert Bly talks about it being a big sack. It's just this big sack we carry with us throughout our life and we put stuff in it. Now, once you start realizing, as you've conformed throughout your life to the script, to this role that society has placed on you or your family has or your religion has, you start realizing that you're not fulfilled because you're not really living the full version of yourself. And you have to start looking into that bag, that shadow. And the problem is there's lots of nasty stuff there that you're afraid of. But there's also things that are good in there that you're also afraid of. Because if you decide as a 40-year-old that you want to take up dancing, like you're not going to become a professional probably, but you're afraid of looking like a fool.
Right.
But you know that if you don't dance, if you don't sing, if you don't write, if you don't do art, that you're not going to really tap into your full aliveness or find out maybe what your purpose in the world is. But you have to go into that messy place. And so that's what's called shadow work, where you start digging with this stuff. And that allows you, as you pull out the things that maybe aren't satisfying, you look at it and try to find the redeemable bits. So the masturbating in public, for example, is that you are a sensual sexual beast and you can never stop being a sensual sexual beast. But there are good ways of expressing that. So you take it out and say, maybe I need to explore this in some good and loving ways.
Right.
But you also pull out the dance piece. And this not only allows you to be more yourself, this isn't about just merely self-fulfillment. It allows you to engage the world differently. So it allows you to be more fully present to others because you're no longer hiding your real self. You're taking it out. You're falling in love with yourself, and that allows you to fall in love with the world and other people, and allows you to create, be generative, to do things in the world. And so, again, what does that have to do with oppression in the Middle East? It has everything to do with that. Because the kind of people we are now is the kind of people who don't do much about that.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of people we are, if we're fully alive, can think of alternatives and new ways of being and speak out against that because they're no longer afraid and vulnerable, raw feeling. They're vulnerable in a life-giving way where they're bold and courageous. And so the shadow has everything to do with it. And societies have shadows. So most people don't know that about drone strikes. They don't really think about it because it's that part of our society that we don't talk about that's submerged.